Hello everyone. Asus routers have many functions. One of these functions is the ability to synchronize the USB drive that is attached to your Asus router, either to the cloud or to an SMB share, or even to another USB drive in case your router has two USB ports. This function is called AiCloud Sync, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate it to you. So the first part of this video, I'm going to demonstrate the AiCloud Sync on a Dropbox account. And in the second part, I'm going to show you how also to synchronize this USB drive to a Windows share that is on your home network. So in this first part, I'm going to show you how to synchronize the USB drive with your Dropbox account. On the right of the screen, this is the Dropbox account, and these are some files and folders in the Dropbox account. On the left, you have the administration page of your Asus router. And here on the bottom, I have the USB share that is shared on your Asus router. If you want to see how to share a USB on your Asus router, I'm going to leave a link in the description below for a video I made earlier explaining how to share USB drive on your Asus router. So the first thing you need to do on your admin page of your Asus router is to go to AiCloud 2.0. And here on the bottom, you have AiCloud Sync. So click on Go. And in AiCloud Sync, you need first to enable it. So click on this button here to toggle it to on and wait for the router to enable it. So now it is enabled. We need to add a new account. And here you have the providers. For each provider, you can have only one account. Web storage is for Asus Cloud. I don't have an Asus Cloud account. You have Dropbox and FTP, Samba and USB. So as I said, in this first part, I'm gonna demonstrate Dropbox. So I'm gonna select Dropbox, and here you have folder. Folder, it means you need to choose the folder on your USB drive that you wanna synchronize with your Dropbox account. And here you can only synchronize the top level folders. And you notice here on my USB drive, I created two folders. One folder is called Dropbox Sync, and the other one is SMBN for the second part of this video. So let's click on browser here, and this is USB drive. Let's expand it, and this is it here. So let's click on Dropbox Sync, and let's click on OK. And I'm gonna open Dropbox Sync here so that for you to see how the files will arrive automatically. Now, the third thing you need to choose is the rule of synchronization. Synchronization, it means a full synchronization between the USB key and your Dropbox account. So let me show you the other options here. You have one way, it means incoming from Dropbox to USB, and you have upload to cloud only. So I'm gonna keep it on synchronization here, and then I'm gonna click on authenticate. So here, click on accept all, and put your Dropbox account, and then click on continue, and put the password for your Dropbox account, and then click on login, and you need here to click on allow. So click allow. And here you need to click on apply and wait for the router to apply the settings. And now it is initializing the synchronization both ways. And you're gonna notice how the files will start populating. So this is the first file, it was copied. And these are the other files. And the videos folder is copied here also. So now the synchronization is finished. So now whatever you change in Dropbox or you change on the USB drive, it will be synchronized. Let me demonstrate this to you. So I'm gonna delete a file here, and it will be deleted from here too automatically. So let me delete it. And let's wait for it here. It will be deleted automatically. And as you saw, it was deleted automatically. So that was the first part. Let me now go to the second part, which is synchronizing a Windows share. So this here is a share on one of my Windows PCs on my local network. And for the router to be able to access the Windows share, you need to enable SMB version 1.0 as a server on your Windows computer. So let me show you how to do this very quickly. On your Windows computer, you need to go to Features, type Features in the search box, and choose Turn Windows Features On or Off, and hit Enter. And it will open the Windows Features. And here you need to scroll until you find SMB 1.0, expand it. And here you have SMB 1.0 server. You need to enable it, and you need to enable the client, and then you click on OK. By the way, if you want me to show you from A to Z how to share a folder on your Windows PC, please leave me a comment in the comments section below, and I'll be more than happy to do a video on this. And if you're liking this video so far, please don't hesitate to give it a thumbs up. This will help my channel greatly. So now what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna do a one-way copy from my Windows PC to the USB drive. So this way, whatever I put in this share on my Windows PC will be copied in the USB drive. So let's go to the root of the USB drive. And here I'm gonna choose this folder as a target for this share. So let me open it so to show you. It is empty now. And let's here go and click on add new account. And by the way, I'm using here my Asus router RTAX 3000, but the instructions I'm showing you apply to all Asus routers that have the AiCloud 2.0 function. And here for the provider, I'm gonna choose Samba. And under server name, you need to put the computer name that you have the share on. So let me show you how to get this. This is a remote connection to the computer where I have the share. To get the computer name, you open a command prompt. And then you key in set computer name. And this is a computer name, so it is whose. So let me minimize the remote desktop connection. So let's put it here. And the shares are not case sensitive in Windows. And for the server IP address, you need to put the IP address of the PC. So let's get the IP address also. So key in ipconfig in the command prompt of the PC. And this is its IP address. So IPv4 address 192.168.69.128. So let's put it here. And under server share folder, you need to put the share name. And the share name, it is temp. And under account and password, you need to put a local account that has access to this share on the PC. So here I know that the local account, it is KST. And I need to put its password here. And under folder, you need to choose the folder on your USB drive that is on your Asus router for it to be the target for the synchronization. So let's click on browser and let's open the USB drive. And here I'm gonna select the high level directory that is SMBN, and then I'm gonna click on OK. And here for the rule, I'm not gonna choose full synchronization. What I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna choose only from the share to the USB disk. So download to USB disk. So this way, whatever I copy in this share, it will be copied in the USB drive. And if I delete something in my USB drive, it will not be deleted from my Windows share. So let's click on apply. And you're gonna notice that it is initializing now. And it's gonna now copy the file. And you see that it copied the folder directly and it finished the synchronization. So let's see what's in the folder. So these are a couple of files in the folder. And I'm gonna just show you here, if I copy anything here, it will be copied to the folder here, SMBN. So let me create any file here. So let's create a file. Let's say it is a bitmap image, enter. It will be copied here instantly. You see how the synchronization was initialized whenever it detected a new file, and it is copied here. So now, as I told you, if you delete it from here, it will not be deleted from the source because the synchronization is only one way. Now, for the Samba share, one thing that you need to do, because we are using the IP of the PC, is to make sure that the IP of the PC will not change. To do this, go in your Asus router admin page to the left here and click on LAN. You need to go to DHCP server and then scroll to the bottom. And you see here you have client name so that you can manually assign IP to this client. So here, click on the drop-down list and you need to choose your PC. So it is called whose. And here you need to click on plus and then apply. I hope that this video was useful to you. In case it was, please share it, subscribe to my channel and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this will help my channel greatly. And this way, you'll not miss my future videos.